Mostly cloudy. Expect fair skies on Monday and Tuesday. And on Wednesday, expect a chance of thunderstorms.
This is Storm Watch. It is brought to you this go around by Giggo.com. The big story coming up will be, of course, a tropical weather update. But first, we've got to take a look at some nasty weather across portions of Oklahoma. Look at this mean line of showers and storms now beginning to cruise right through the heart of Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. Already this morning, we've had winds gusting up to 90 miles per hour as this line of showers and storms moved through Woodward County and nearby Woodward itself. And now we're looking at some winds gusting between 40 up to about 60 miles per hour in and around Oklahoma City, Oklahoma, with some blinding rain. That's going to be the big story. And it's all heading on towards the southeast, as you can clearly see. Tornadic thunderstorms, basically no. Straight line winds, now that's going to be the big concern for the next hour or two as these storms continue to sweep and march towards the southeast. Looks like a near miss for Tulsa, Oklahoma. You could be maybe getting on the northern fringe of this within the next, let's say, 30 to 45 minutes. But right now, it's really in the heart of Oklahoma City. You're looking at the worst of the weather at the present time. Nationwide, this is the main story. Come later on today, we're going to be looking at more showers and storms redeveloping to the south and east of Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. So stand by southwestern Arkansas, to around Shreveport, Louisiana, Longview and Lufkin in Texas, and maybe getting real close to Dallas and Fort Worth too, especially north and east of you a little bit later on. Tropical weather right now, what is going on? Well, the first thing we're going to be doing is taking a look at what's happening across the Pacific. Yes, the Pacific Ocean, first of all. A string of pearls right in through here, and well to the southwest of there is our tropical storm Upana, which is now moving westward, and we will continue to do so all weekend long at 12 miles per hour. Top sustained winds 40 miles per hour, and closer inspection of what's happening with our tropical storm seems to be losing a lot of its convection right now, which means it could begin to fade away. Clearly, well south of the Hawaiian chain, moving away right now towards the west. So any impact on Hawaii itself and the islands? None whatsoever. Maybe some heavier surf within the next 12 or 18 hours, but overall, this is a very, very weak system. Looks like it's getting weaker by the very, very moment. Let's come back to the Atlantic Basin right now. During the month of July, the hot spots in the red, the Caribbean, off the coast of the southeastern United States, into the Gulf of Mexico. And of course, June and July, relatively quiet on average. That normally is what is happening. But by the time you get into mid to late August, into September, now this is the heart of the hurricane season. So we have a long ways to go, a long season yet to go. So don't let your guard down, because on average, June and July, hardly anything forms. And whatever does form is really isolated, and not much does form during June and July. The biggest and also the heart of the hurricane season is yet to come. So now is the time to start preparing and planning. What would I do if a hurricane's heading towards my area, in my part of the coastline? Start thinking about that right now when it's relatively a quiet time. Let's see what's happening right now from the islands on towards the west. Looks great, doesn't it? Including around the Gulf of Mexico. Some debris left over some afternoon showers and storms from Friday afternoon, but overall, a calm morning. No rain is situated anywhere throughout the Gulf Coast as of the present time. Farther on towards the east, we'll see what's happening all the way from Puerto Rico back towards Jamaica. Looks fine right now. Could be a few isolated showers building up over land, but overall, it should not be that big of a deal. And off the coast of Mexico, we've been following this feature right in through here. A tropical depression, maybe a tropical storm. Looks rather unhealthy right now, but it could become a tropical depression as time goes on. And the farther west we go, there's always something seems to be going on right around the Philippines. Another depression right now is causing a lot of heavy rains. We have to monitor this situation for more mudslides and more heavy rain as the weekend wears on. Your national forecast right now, the big story right now at the present hour, the big time storms around Oklahoma City, Oklahoma. But otherwise, for most of the country all weekend long, relatively cool and relatively quiet as well. Rainfall chances minimal across most of the country, and hot weather really confined to the southwestern part of the country and South Texas for this upcoming day today.
This program was sponsored by Giggo.com. We've got this car thing down.
All right, maggot, let's talk about your lunch money.
Yeah, your lunch money.
Oh, this is the $5 that I owe you for today, and this should cover the rest of the week.
Wow.
You're the man.
That was painless. Why Giggo.com, where you take control of buying a car. Research it, finance it, buy it. Giggo.com, we've got this car thing down.
Michelin would like to remind you, there's only one safety feature on the road that actually...
Media Camping Center of Fairless Hills, Pennsylvania is the area's largest full-service RV dealer. With hundreds of RVs in stock ranging in sizes, styles, and colors, we're sure to have the perfect RV for you, making your next RV purchase easy and exciting. In business since 1964, we know that selling for less and giving you more is the reason why more and more customers continue to buy at Media Camping Center. For your next RV purchase, come to the area's largest full-service RV dealer, Media Camping Center in Fairless Hills, Pennsylvania.
It's time for your local forecast on the Weather Channel. Currently in your area, 75 degrees under fair skies. Your forecast. Expect fair skies on Monday and Tuesday, and on Wednesday, expect a chance of thunderstorms.
An update on the risk of severe weather in the southern plains is coming up momentarily during this edition of Storm Watch. I'm Bob Stokes. But first, our hurricane expert, Dr. Steve Lyons, is sitting by with an update on the tropics. Steve? Yes, let's get an update on the chance of severe weather across the southern plains. The severe thunderstorm watch that has been in effect for much of the morning has been whittled down considerably, but still the risk of severe weather around Texarkana presently. We've seen some strong storms, quite active, moving out of Oklahoma southeastward, and we still have that risk of severe weather along the Red River Valley. including Lake Texoma. Getting into the Metroplex, not out of the question. And Sherman, you could see some thunderstorms, and you could see I-40 being affected potentially by some strong winds and some hail, as well as heavy downpours. Let's find out what's going on. Let's get an update on a squall line that's been moving southeastward for a good chunk of the morning. Not quite as strong as it was earlier when it was moving through McAllister. It's broken up a little bit, but still a couple of pieces of high cloud tops, a couple of pieces of strong cells moving toward the southeast, right toward I-30, not far from Arkadelphia, and say just southwest of Hot Springs. So please beware as these move toward the east-southeast, and these cells are containing possibly some wind gusts in excess of 50 miles per hour. Heavy rainfall, Fort Smith, all the way back toward the southeastern part of Oklahoma. You and Little Rock, beware. If you had planned on going out today, it looks like some showers and storms not far to your west. And there's the accompanying lightning across the borderline of Texas and Arkansas. Also some lightning, too, around the Tampa-St. Petersburg area, where we've seen quite a bit of storm activity this morning. But let's take a look at areas just north of the lightning. We have at least some rainfall just south of Kansas City. And you can see also some storms around the Ozark Plateau, not far from Springfield, Missouri, where a chance of storms continuing again around the Arklatex. And in the southeast, by the way, some instability around Tampa. Look at these storms just flare up during the past couple of hours. So it's a messy time for vacationers, say driving from Atlanta down to Orlando to Disney World. You're having to run into some developing storms. And as we focus in closer, just about the entire west coast, is certainly the west central coast of Florida, looking messy and stormy right now. We'll have an update.
Forecast. Expect mostly cloudy skies on Monday and Tuesday, and on Wednesday, expect a chance of rain.
Hello and welcome to this edition of Storm Watch. If you live in southern Mississippi in Hancock County, you are underneath a tornado warning at this hour. We'll have a look at all the severe thunderstorms and severe weather throughout the southeast in just a few minutes, but we begin the Storm Watch by looking at the tropics. And this Storm Watch is brought to you by American Power Conversion. And as we look into the Atlantic, things are still quiet. I know we've been saying that for the past several weeks. That's wonderful news to hear if you have vacation or if you live in the southeast or along the east coast, but this doesn't mean that the rest of the hurricane season is expected to be this quiet. Let's look at a few features that we notice in through the Atlantic, and right off the African coast, we are noticing it's really hard to pick out an area of low pressure at the surface. It's hard to pick out because there isn't any convection with it. We're going to continue to monitor the situation, but right now it doesn't look like it will be developing into anything. But if it does, believe me, we'll be the first to let you know. And you always want to tune back into the Weather Channel at least once a day to watch the Storm Watch, or maybe even twice a day to see if there's anything new developing. Now let's move into the Caribbean. And in through the southwestern Caribbean, we're noticing some showers and thunderstorms. However, the good news with these thunderstorms is that they're a little bit closer to land to really develop into anything. They don't look like they'll have enough time. But this area is favorable for some conditions, so we'll continue to monitor the southern western portions of the Caribbean. And now let's move out into the Pacific. And what really grabs our attention is an area of low pressure that is not very strong, but it is spinning in the Pacific, and it's actually going to be moving into some cooler water. That's why we don't think this system will develop into anything. Now let's go into let's go farther out into the Pacific and look at our tropical storm as it moves well to the south of you in the Hawaiian Islands. It is continuing to move to the west, and it's really hard to pick out. It is this cluster right here, and it is slowly starting to weaken as it moves again away from you and is not going to be any affecting you in through the Hawaiian Islands. So let's go back to the lower 48 and watch for those strong thunderstorms. And we even have severe thunderstorm watch boxes posted for the southeast. And if you live in Jackson, Mississippi, you're underneath a severe thunderstorm watch. Also for Columbia and Raleigh, Durham and the Charlotte area, you're underneath a severe thunderstorm watch. But let's look up close. And in Hancock County, right now you are underneath a tornado warning. So need to take cover if you live in Diamond Head or into the Gulf or Bay of St. Louis area. Also in through portions of Gulfport and Biloxi, or rather we're seeing some very strong thunderstorms develop across this area, right in through southern portions of Mississippi, and they do extend into Santa Rosa and also portions of the Panhandle, so some very strong thunderstorms developing at this hour. Now let's move into the Carolinas, where we've been noticing some strong thunderstorms as well, right along Interstate 95, staying through eastern South Carolina and also into eastern portions of North Carolina. Throughout southern Georgia, some very strong thunderstorms and ones with some strong gusty winds and possibly some hail. We also have rain throughout central Florida, and that is going to continue for at least the next few hours and then slowly start to weaken. Now let's move into the plains, where we have been noticing some strong thunderstorms developing, especially in through eastern and central, or rather central portions of Nebraska and also into western portions of Kansas, some strong thunderstorms at this hour, and they're likely to continue for tonight.
This program was sponsored by American Power Conversion, legendary reliability.
Can your business afford downtime due to bad power? Can your enterprise avoid power disruptions? Who ensures availability for more networks worldwide? APC. Power management solutions wherever data is created, transmitted, or stored. For a free downtime analysis, go to iwantapc.com.
Now I have the time of my life,
and I owe it all to...
Expect a chance of rain.
We begin this storm watch talking about tornadoes in through southeastern Colorado. You are underneath a tornado warning if you live in Bent and Baca County for at least the next 30 minutes. This is in the southeastern corner of the state. If you live just in Springfield as well as Walsh and Pritchett, you need to take cover immediately. This tornado has a history of producing some very damaging winds, also golf ball to baseball size hail, and it has been a long history with this tornado. It went through Bent County earlier in the town of McClave, and it has moved to the south and entered into Baca County, and it is continuing to move to the south. If it holds together, it will be pushing into the panhandle of Oklahoma and into Texas. So I want you to take cover immediately again if you live in Baca County in southeastern Colorado. Now let's shift gears and talk about the tropics. And looking across the Atlantic, we're still seeing some relatively quiet conditions as we get in a little bit closer to the African coast. Not too much convection, but we do see an area of low pressure that we're continuing to monitor and where it's hard to even see because there's not a lot of convection with it. But it should be continuing to move to the west, and if it does get a little bit of convection going, maybe something worthwhile, and so we'll keep our eyes on that. Meanwhile, as we go into the Caribbean and into the Gulf of Mexico, we have seen some showers and thunderstorms fire up in the southwestern Caribbean. But as you can see, they're kind of running into land. They're very close to land, so if they do form into anything, they'll have a pretty tough time doing that since they are so close to the vicinity of a land mass. Meanwhile, let's move over into the Pacific, and we're watching a tropical depression. It's to the southeast of the Baja, and it is winds right now are around 35 miles an hour. It will continue to move to the west northwest and be no threat to land, and it is expected to weaken over the next 2 days. Also expecting to weaken is another depression, this one just to the south of Hawaii, more than 700 miles away, so that's not even close to the Hawaiian Islands. It is continuing to move to the west and continues to weaken at this hour. Again, this is no threat to the Hawaiian Islands, nor each depression is not going to be a threat to the Hawaiian Islands. So wonderful news in the eastern Pacific at this hour. Meanwhile, we do have those thunderstorms going on in through southern portion, southeastern Colorado, and also into Nebraska and across the southeastern portion of the country. Strong thunderstorms to severe thunderstorms can be expected overnight into the panhandle of Oklahoma as well as into the panhandle of Texas. And we are watching the strong thunderstorms also out in through central Nebraska. Custard, Garfield counties, you have seen tremendous amount of severe weather move through. Warnings after warnings have been going on, and we're still seeing those showers and thunderstorms firing up. These are very isolated, severe, active weather coming in this evening, and the radar estimated pre-ship is showing you that. Not a whole lot of rain in through the central plains, but where we do have the rain, we have about an inch of rain to 2 inches coming down. This is the path of that tornadic cell that continued to move through Bent County and now is in Baca County, where we are underneath a tornado warning if you live in Baca County. We also have those strong thunderstorms producing about a half an inch of rain across portions of Nebraska. Let's move into the southeast, and wet weather continues, but more scattered active weather across portions of the panhandle. We still have some heavy rain in through South Carolina for Charleston and also into the Myrtle Beach area. Cloudy conditions across the northeast at this hour, an area of low pressure. You can see it spinning as it moves in to eastern Maine. We have been noticing a few scattered showers across the upstate of New York and also some showers pushing through Maine, but right along the coast. Not too bad of a day, and things are going to be improving for you in Maine. For you in Kennebunk, Booth Bay, looks like it'll be a nice day for tomorrow. A few morning showers are possible, morning clouds, and then a lot of that wet weather will be moving to the east. But the wet weather is not really going anywhere in the southeast for tomorrow. We still have the stationary front sagged over the southeast, and that is going to help generate more showers and a few more thunderstorms for the afternoon and into the evening hours. So look out for that if you live into Georgia, South Carolina, and into Florida.
You know, when you apply for a loan in today's economy, it's nice to have the confidence that your credit is good, especially when you need a new home, car, or other essential. But sometimes inaccuracies do appear in your credit report. And that's why it's so important to stay on top of your credit by checking your report from time to time. Now it's easy and it's free. To get a free copy of your credit report, simply log on to freecreditreport.com. Act now. Get your free credit report by logging on to freecreditreport.com today.
Problem?
The doctor says my cholesterol's still too high.
What about diet and exercise?
They didn't do enough.
So?
He suggested adding Lipitor.
Lipitor, the number one prescribed medication for lowering cholesterol. In clinical studies, Lipitor with diet was proven to lower bad cholesterol 39 to 60%. Total cholesterol.